Now in this video, we talk about the main components of an internal combustion engine. So if you look at this diagram on the board, this will indicate the major components that are there in the IC engine. Okay, let's start. The very first one is this outer body, which we call the cylinder. It houses the piston inside it and the other components we will be just discussing about. So this body, which is housing the piston inside, this is called cylinder. It's a vertical device with a circular cross section. Okay, now there are two holes cut on the top surface of the cylinder which houses these valves. So these are valves which are spring loaded, okay, and they are operated with the help of a cam mechanism. So you have a cam mechanism, and these two valves are, one of them is the inlet valve, the other one is the outlet valve. Okay, so I'll write down inlet or exhaust valve. Okay, now if you have to recognize which one is what, which one is an inlet valve or which one is an exhaust valve, then you look at the, you know, the diameter of the valve. How big is it or how small is it? The bigger valve is always the inlet valve and the smaller one is the exhaust valve. Okay, now why do we keep the inlet valve of a slightly larger diameter as compared to the exhaust valve, so as to increase the volumetric efficiency at the end of the stroke? Okay, so that is why the inlet valve is a slightly bigger diameter valve as compared to the exhaust valve. Okay, always remember that. Now this part in which you are housing these valves, this is called the cylinder head. This is called the cylinder head. Now cylinder head means, cylinder head is that part of the cylinder in which you have the valve housing assembly and also this part. Now what is this part? Now if this is an SI engine or a petrol engine or an autocycle engine, then this would be a spark plug. This would be a spark plug, because the ignition method is the spark ignition method in an SI engine. Okay, if it is a diesel engine, then this would be a fuel injector. So there has to be a differentiation. So fuel injector for diesel engine, because fuel is injected directly with the help of a fuel pump in a diesel cycle, but you know, with the help of carburetor in a, you can say an SI cycle. So the fuel air mixture from the carburetor in an SI engine would come directly via the inlet valve, okay, would get compressed, and spark plug would initiate the sparking or ignition of that air fuel mixture. Okay, so we are pre-mixing the air and fuel and then allowing it into inside the cylinder. But in the case of a diesel engine, the air is sucked in via this inlet valve, only the air. The fuel is then put in via this fuel injector, which comes from the fuel pump. So this is a difference, or you can say you can differentiate between the two type of engines. Now let's move ahead. This part inside it is called the piston of the engine. So this is the piston. Let me mark this. This is the piston. Okay, now you have a funny looking shape on top of the piston. Okay, so first of all, this part, this top surface, is called the piston land. Okay, so there is a topmost surface of the piston. Now there is a funny looking cavity on the piston land. This is where the air fuel mixture or the air or whatever the combustion mixture is, it swirls, it circulates, or it combusts. So this part is called the combustion chamber. This part is called the combustion chamber, and this specific shape of the combustion chamber is called the Mexican hat. You can have a lot of shapes of combustion chamber for different power outputs. Okay, you have a hemispherical combustion chamber, you have different kinds of combustion chamber for different kind of power outputs. Okay, now a very distinct feature of piston. If you look at the piston closely, let me draw it in a separate diagram. Okay, I'll draw a simplistic diagram. So let us draw a center line. So this piston is slightly tapered at the bottom. Okay, not this much taper, you will not see it with the naked eyes, but this, there is some angle which is there over here. So this taper is there. Now why is this taper, first of all? Okay, or what is this taper called? So this taper at the bottom is called the piston skirt. Okay, now why do we have this kind of a taper? Now see, the maximum temperature of the piston would be in this area, because you'll be having combustion in this area. Okay, so during combustion the temperatures are very, very high, so you need to have some allowances for expansion of the piston land, or of the top surface, or the top region of the piston. So when it expands, it actually becomes straight. So this angle actually becomes zero when the piston expands due to combustion and hot temperatures in the top region of the piston. So you can say that this taper is an expansion allowance due to high temperatures. Okay. Now if this was not there, if we did not have this piston skirt or this tapering of the piston, then this would eventually expand. This has to expand because there are very high temperatures on the top surface of the piston. So it would expand, and upon expansion it would stick to the cylinder walls, and you will have metal to metal contact, and it will jam the whole process. The reciprocation would stop. Okay, so that is why we have this allowance for expansion. This is very, very small, not very high. Okay, so you have this piston skirt at the bottom and the piston land at the top. Now you might be seeing these zigzag cavities or zigzag grooves on the piston, and these blue colored hatchings. So what are these? So if I draw a cross section only of this much area, so it would be something like this. Okay, so this part, these kind of things on the piston are called piston ring grooves. These are grooves in which you will be seating your piston rings. Okay, and these blue colored lines over in that diagram, this hatching that we have shown, this is basically the cross section of your piston ring. Now if you look at this diagram, there is some allowance, some clearance between the piston and the cylinder wall. The piston is not directly in touch with the cylinder. Now we are making, or we are putting these piston rings over here, and these piston rings are in touch with the cylinder wall. Okay, and these piston rings, let me first of all annotate them. So these are the piston rings. Okay, so the purpose of piston rings is that the top ring is basically a sealing ring. Whatever combustion pressure you develop in the combustion chamber, it will not allow it to leak off through this clearance. It will keep this pressure intact in this combustion area. Okay, so the top ring, let me write it down, the top ring, this is called pressure ring. Okay, now the last two rings, the last two rings, These are called oil scraper rings. Oil scraper rings. Now what happens is, you have your crankcase at the bottom. I'll come to that. You have your crankcase at the bottom. Okay. You have your lube oil sump at the bottom. In this lube oil sump, you have your lube oil stored. Now, there are different ways to actually lubricate your cylinder. So, there is, let us say, there is splash lubrication, or even if there is, feed pump, or you can say lube oil feed pump lubrication. So, you'll have some lube oil sticking to these cylinder walls. Okay, so you'll have some lube oil sticking to these cylinder walls. Now, what happens is, due to eventual wear and tear of these rings, this lube oil which is sticking to the cylinder wall for lubrication purposes, this gets carried away into the combustion chamber and eventually takes part in the combustion process, which leads to corrosion of the exhaust and inlet valves, and also produces black smoke, and also consumes the lube oil from the lube oil sump, which is not good for your engine health. The lubricating pressure will drop and the lubrication efficiency will also drop. So to avoid that and to keep your lube oil within the sump, these two rings, they keep on scraping this oil back into the sump. So they'll scrape these cylinder walls and put this oil back into the sump. So this is what the function of the oil scraper rings are. Okay, now in comparison to the piston material, the rings are of a softer material. Okay, now to replace a piston, it's very, very expensive. Okay, because that's an integral part of your internal combustion function. So these rings, which have direct metal to metal contact, and they are softer as compared to the cylinder material also, because cylinder is also a very, very expensive part to replace, because it houses all these things. Okay, so whenever there is some wear and tear, the wear and tear happens on these rings. So we take out the piston, change these rings, and put the piston back into the cylinder. So this is what this is the advantage of using piston rings. First is to maintain the pressure in the combustion chamber. Second is to scrape off the extra oil from the cylinder walls. And third, that the material of these piston rings is comparatively softer as compared to piston and cylinder, so it calls for economical maintenance due to wear and tear. Okay, so this is what these things are. Now let's come to the bottom of the engine. So you have this, you have piston, cylinder, and you have this, which is called a connecting rod, or in short we also call it the conned rod. Okay, now conned rod has two ends. One end of the conned rod is connecting the piston, and the other end of the conned rod, which is the bigger end, is connecting the crankshaft. So this is the crank, and this is the crankshaft hub. This is the crankshaft hub. Okay, so the conned rod is connecting the piston and the crank, or the crankshaft. Okay, now this end of the conned rod is called the big eye, the big end. Okay, and this end of the conned rod is called the small eye, or the small end. Okay, now there has to be a method to join the piston and the small eye of the conned rod. Yes, there is. So we put a pin inside these two parts, which is called a gudgeon pin or a piston pin in the simpler language. You put a pin over here. So that pin is holding the piston, or connecting the piston and the conned rod, and that is called the piston pin, or it is also known as the gudgeon pin. Okay, so now it's making a sense that you have piston which is running in the cylinder up and down, you have piston rings. Now piston and crank are connected with the help of a conned rod, conned rod and piston are connected with the help of a piston pin. Okay, so this is a very, very simplistic method of telling you the major components of an IC engine. I hope you understood the detailing that we discussed in this particular video. Now, in the next video, we talk about the air fuel mixture.